Hi, my name is Laura Cruz. I am a program manager in the System Center Advisor team. I've been working on Advisor for the past year, and today I'd like to walk you through this great product. The name of this course is System Center Advisor, and it has four modules. Some of the things we will cover in this course are an overview of how Advisor works, the benefits of using Advisor, and the supported workloads. We'll also go through the different features available today in the Advisor portal. I will also guide you through high-level architecture for Advisor and the deployment options that exist today. And in the last module of this course, I'll cover integration with Operations Manager, where I'll show you how to reap the benefits of Advisor using only an Operations Manager deployment. So to kick things off, I'll begin with the overview module by showing you how Advisor works behind the scenes, sharing the benefits of Advisor, the workloads we support, and international availability. So to begin with, normally customers call Microsoft support after an issue has come up in their environment, and they work with our support team to resolve the problem. In order for support to know how their environment is configured, they may request a configuration manifest to check if there are any known issues. After support looks at the configuration manifest, they will provide some ways to remediate the problem. In many cases, support will also publish an article to our knowledge base so users know about the problem and how to fix it. Now, what the support team saw was that there were thousands upon thousands of cases coming up that could have been avoided by routine configuration maintenance. For a lot of these issues, support immediately knew the fix and already had articles available. And that's where Advisor comes in. We realized that we could automate this process, provide best practices as soon as a potential configuration problem was detected. And the automated recommendations that Advisor provides are based on what we've learned from other users with similar configurations. Now, this analysis that Advisor performs happens in Microsoft data centers, so there is little to no performance hit on the user's own resources. The service runs on the cloud, which also gives Microsoft the ability to update it frequently with new rules and capabilities. The recommendations that Advisor provides are given through alerts, and they are actionable. They include links to KB articles or other documentation needed to resolve the issue. And that's in one slide how Advisor came to be and how it works. So I'd like to share with you what are the benefits of using Advisor. And at the very core, what we want to do is help you proactively avoid configuration problems. You will receive alerts for unpatched, misconfigured, or unsupported configurations. You can also prevent problems that have already happened to others and compare your environment with Microsoft best practices. Now, if you do run into an issue, Advisor will help you resolve it faster. With Advisor, you will get historical and current configuration data, which you can then share with Microsoft support to help troubleshoot the problem. And this is all available for free today at systemcenteradvisor.com. Now, like I mentioned earlier, you can also use Advisor as an attached service to Operations Manager. In addition to the benefits of the previous slide, you will also get easier enablement. Since Advisor ships out of the box with Operations Manager 2012R2, there is no need to run a separate installer for Advisor. You will also be able to view Advisor alerts within the Operations Manager console, and you can also leverage Operations Manager's notification, ticketing integration, and user role capabilities on the Advisor alerts. So if you're on System Center 2012R2, Operations Manager, you already have the option of enabling Advisor as an attached service. The Advisor connector is also available on the Microsoft Download Center for users on Operations Manager 2012 SP1. Next, we'll go into how Advisor works and its high-level architecture. You will see I have two environments in my diagram, and both are talking to the Advisor service. The one on the left is running Advisor on its own, and the one on the right is using Advisor as an attached service to Operations Manager. For those of you not familiar with Operations Manager provides real-time monitoring, while Advisor provides proactive knowledge. I'll begin with the Advisor-only environment, and later show you how it's similar to an environment with Advisor as an attached service. There's two main components to understand about Advisor, and those are Agent and Gateway. There's the Advisor Agent, which collects data throughout the day for your workloads. Then that information is sent to the Advisor Gateway. The Gateway is what connects your servers to the cloud. The good thing is that only the gateway needs to be connected to the internet. It talks to the cloud and lets the service know what version of Advisor it's running. If there are any new rules available, the service will provide them to the gateway, which will download them and propagate them down to the agents. So there's really no additional work needed for you to do in order to keep getting new Advisor rules. Now, moving on to the attached service environment, you will notice that the Operations Manager servers perform a similar role as the Advisor Gateway. And instead of having to install the Advisor agents, you can reuse the already deployed Operation Manager agents. Once you enable Advisor as an attached service in Operations Manager, the OM agents will collect configuration data and send it to the management servers. These management servers will take that information and send it to the cloud for analysis, and it will also check for any updates on rules. Once Advisor analyzes your configuration, the alerts will be available both in the Advisor portal, like in the earlier example, but now they will also appear in the Operations Manager console. Later on in this course, I will show you how to deploy Advisor and how to enable Advisor as an attached service in Operations Manager. As of this recording, in January 2014, these are the workloads that Advisor supports. We originally started out with SQL and Windows Server checks only, but as you can see, we've expanded to other server workloads like Link Server, SharePoint, Exchange, and Hyper-V. And the most recent workload we've added is System Center 2012 SP1, Virtual Machine Manager. So Advisor can verify the configuration for all of these workloads against what our support team has found out and provide you with proactive recommendations that will avoid problems further down the road. Now, we take privacy very seriously, so I'd like to include some key points on data privacy. As always, the complete privacy statement is available in the footer of systemcenteradvisor.com. But the key points that I'd like to make today is that Advisor only has visibility into the servers with agents deployed on them and the data queried from Active Directory about the objects associated with these servers. The uploaded configuration data is also archived on-premise, and it's there 5 days by default. And this will serve as an audit trail that will enable you to inspect the data since it's stored as XML files. Upload time is configurable. You can make it more frequent, but you can also stop uploading data to Advisor at any time. We hope it doesn't come to this, but you can close your account and request to remove all data from Advisor servers, and this cleanup will happen within 90 days. And the last couple of points I'd like to stress is that your organization will be the only non-Microsoft party who will have access to your individual organization's data. Microsoft will not use this data for any sales or licensing validation. We'll only use it to assess your configuration and provide you with recommendations. Now, regarding availability, Advisor is free today at systemcenteradvisor.com. You can also get it out of the box through Operations Manager 2012 R2. And if you're running Operations Manager 2012 SP1, you can download the Advisor connector at the Microsoft Download Center. It is also recommended that you install the latest update rollup for Operations Manager 2012 SP1 if you're using the Advisor connector. Regarding international availability, these are the current locations where Advisor is currently supported. Advisor analyzes data in a United States server data center. So we recommend you check the international availability page if you have any questions about Advisor support in your location. The linked page can be seen below on the slide as well. So before wrapping up this first module, I'd like to point out the key takeaways from this course. And the first is what Advisor does. Advisor provides proactive configuration monitoring for Windows Server and server workloads. The second takeaway is that it's absolutely free. And the third one is that if you're already using Operations Manager 2012 R2, you already have it out of the box as an attached service.